Hello students, how are you all? Hi Abhishek, hi Anuj, hello Sumit, hi Shrilekha, hi Renisa, how are you all my lovely kids? Welcome to today's amazing session, and today we are going to have the second session on After Blenheim by Robert Sade, and I hope all of you have seen the video, the previous video that I uploaded for you all. Yes or no? Okay. अरे लाइव चैट क्या हो गया बच्चा लोग? गुड आफ्टरनून सविता जी, गुड आफ्टरनून. हाय महमूद अहमद, हाय सरायु, हाय गीता, हाउ आर यू ऑल? सो ऑल ऑफ यू हैड सीन द प्रीवियस वीडियो एंड देन केम टू दिस सेशन, राइट? Thank you, Kanchan. Thank you so much. Did you all see the video, previous one? The first session on After Blenheim, have you understood? And yes, I'm also going to read out your comments regarding the answer. The question that I asked was, do you think, what are your views on war? And do you think war is necessary evil? So many people have come up with different comments. So I'm going to read out few of your answers. And yes, I'm going to also take the doubts which you have posted in the previous session on After Blenheim. Are, thank you, Akanksha. Thank you so much. Are, thank you, Satyashi. Thank you so much. CBSC ke bhi bachche hain. That's great. As I always keep telling you that in English, English is such a subject which does not create the boundaries between ICSC and CBSC or state board. So all of you can have the session, like all of you can enjoy the beauty of the poem, right? So yes, all of you can join me, all of you can watch the videos so that you can actually get the feel the beauty of the poem and understand what is the poet telling us, what is the message conveyed, and so that you can apply it in your lives as well, right? So now let me read out some of your answers, and yes, after that I'm going to take some doubts as well. So the first answer that I want to read out is by Aditya Narayan Pradhan. He has written, war is never a solution and of any problem. It is always futile. Many people lose their lives in war. Exactly. Someone loses his brother, someone his son, his husband, etc. Very good. Very good, Aditya. Keep it up. Keep up your answers. Good answer. Great, great, great. And next is, Runa has asked me a doubt. Why does the poet use a skull? Which is a very important question. I think all of you should know this answer. So the poet in this poem uses a skull so that he... by the use of the skull, it's actually a symbol which emphasizes the futility of war and the destruction caused by these great wars, right? So that is why the poet has used skull in the poem to talk about the destruction, right? That is caused by the war. And aur kisi ne kuch likha hai to main pad deti hu. Another one by Aditya is, why is the Battle of Blenheim the greatest battle? Yes, so in this poem, the grandfather actually calls this After Blenheim, the Battle of Blenheim, as the greatest battle because it resulted in English victory, right? So he was kind of conditioned about the war being romantic. So he romanticized the idea of war. Now, what do I mean when I say that he romanticized the idea of war? That means he considered war as something glorious. Okay, so that is the way how we are also conditioned towards believing that war is something that should be glorified. The warriors are the people who should be glorified because of their courage. But we hardly try to empathize with the human beings, those who actually face the struggle, those who actually, have the first-hand and direct experience on the war front. So here the great battle, the so-called great battle, is used ironically by the poet by constantly, where he constantly emphasizes on the futility of the so-called great wars. What is great about the war if it is causing huge destruction, if it is causing systematic butchery of young lives, right? So the word great is used as, you know, an irony in the poem. And I hope with this, your doubts are absolutely clear. And now we are ready to start with the mentee quiz. Are you all ready? Start, please. Hanji, Dheeraj ji, zarur start karenge. Pehle to doubt clear karna padega na, so that nothing, no element of doubt is there in your mind. Okay, Sanju is saying the word itself brings fear to the minds of innocent civilians. Exactly. It is a facade. Exactly. War is a facade, a mask, a trick made by the greater people, which leads to colossal wastage of people. Very well answered, Sanju. Amazing answer. Great inputs coming from you all. Great. I'm really very happy to see all of your comments. Right? New banner and uniform. Beta, uniform to pehle se hi tha, bas banner new hai. Yes, beyond the music. Okay, so now we will be starting off with the mentee quiz. The code is 576747. Okay, ye hai aapka mentee code. And you have to, acha, hum log abhi Vedantu Pro subscription ka baat kar lete hain. So if you haven't yet subscribed, then please do visit the link below. Link aapke description box mein diya hua hai. Use the teacher code SWRPRO. And the discount price is 2699. So in order to avail the discount, you have to use the teacher's code SWRPRO. So I would love to see you all joining Vedantu family. So please do subscribe, follow these simple steps, select grade, select target, get subscription, and then choose your plan using the code SWRPRO. And I also received mails regarding, ma'am, how to subscribe. Ek do bachcho ne mujhe mail kiya hai. To un bachcho ko main keh rahi hu, please follow these steps in order to subscribe to the Vedantu Pro subscription. And all of you, please join Vedantu Pro subscription and be a member of our family. Ek bar, ek mahine ke liye lekar dekho. It is a real fun and it will be really amazing and a wonderful experience. And yes, what are the features that you are going to get? Complete curriculum, structured long-term batch, which is in sync with your curriculum, chapter-wise micro courses, complete crash course. And the best part is you can all, you know, you can have the freedom to study on your own according to your plan. And yes, you have the availability of test series, assignments, learning materials, and regular performance reports. Live interactive classes by India's best master teachers, personalized attention in class, full recordings of classes along with notes, assignment, tests and more. And ye hai aapka code 576747. So please guys, join the mentee quiz and clear all your doubts. Is quiz ke baad, I can assure you that you are not going to have any more doubts in your mind. And I hope you have visited the previous video and everything is clear. Now you are ready to be in the mentee quiz and you are ready to have your name on the leaderboard as well. Are you guys ready? Give me a quick let's rock. Yes, Poonam ji, what doubt you have? Please tell me. Speak in English. What am I speaking in? I'm speaking in English only. Anji Vandana. I'm good, Kanchan. Yes, Poonam. Instead of writing the word doubt, please ask your doubt so that I can tell you. Hi, Harshil. I've taken your name. Okay, so give me a quick let's rock and let's start off with the... Are Sunita, I'm not ignoring you. Okay, so ready to start and let's have the first question. Who wrote the poem? This is the most, this is the easiest question. William Wordsworth, Matthew Arnold, Robert Sade. Yes, Arya, tell me what is your problem? What is your doubt? How can I join? Go to menti.com and use the code 576747. Very good. All of you have, most of you have given the correct answer. And those of you who have not given the correct answer, I think you did not go through the poem and did not see the video. You are just making a wild guess. So, bachcho, aisa nahi karna hai. You have to go through the video and then come to the Menti quiz. Okay? Don't come to Menti quiz without going through the video. Otherwise, you will not be able to give the answers correctly. Right? Of course, Piyush, you can join us. It's not William Wordsworth, Abhinav. It's Robert Sade. And yes, one of you asked me, to which country did Robert Sade belong? And I would love to answer that. He was born in Bristol in England. Okay? So let's have a look at the leaderboard. Pet is, I don't know where. She's roaming around here and there. Okay. So we have the leaderboard with us. Aditya is the fastest and has also secured the first position. Anshul, Himanshu, Vroom, Jerry, Palak, Shivan, Sonakshi, Harsh, and Simran. Very good. Amazing. Amazing. Yes, Vivek, tell me your problem. What type of poem is After Blenheim? War poem, romantic poem, anti-war poem. Come on. Okay, so this is an anti-war poem, okay? So, why is After Blenheim an anti-war poem? Because it constantly, tears off the veil of romance. So, the romanticism that is associated with war, it is constantly hammering upon the romantic feature of war, and it is constantly questioning the idea of glorification of war. So therefore, this is an anti-war poem. And let's have a look at the leaderboard now. Okay, Himanshu, Palak, Simran, Manthan, Ayush, Dhruv, Stinglicious, is it like that? Hula Hoop, ye sab kya naam hai bhai? Fastest, okay? Hula Hoop is the fastest. Sharayu Beast Slayer, very good, very good. Next question is, where was the skull found? In the garden, in the field, beside the rivulet, in the village. Yes, Kaustav, I've taken your name. Very good. Most of you have given the correct answer. Beside the rivulet in the village. That was the place where the skull was found. Let's have a look at the leaderboard. Hi, Neeraj. Okay, so we have Simran, Sharayu, Prakriti, Stinglicious, Pooja, Daddy's Princess. Okay, Ayush. Rishabh loves English. That's great. Manthan, Rohan is the fastest. And Dhriti. Very well done. Very well done. And by him, sported on the green, identify the figure of speech. Metonymy, metaphor, both. Okay, let's see how many of you get this correct. Oh, so many of you got it incorrect. It's not a metaphor. It's a metonymy. That means aap logon ne video nahi dekhi hai. At the end of the video, I also spoke about the figures of speech that has been used. So please revisit the video and see the figures of speech. So, and sported on the green. So green is used for what? Anyone? That means aap logon ne nahi dekha hai video. I'm very sad because of that. Green is used for the grassland, okay? So therefore, that is the figure of speech, metonymy that has been used. Please, for the explanation part, please do see, I have elaborately explained that. So please do watch the video. यस हाँ, बोलने के बाद तो ग्रासलैंड बोलोगे ही. ओके, सो स्टिंगलिशियस इज द फास्टेस्ट. सिमरन, आयुष, ये क्या है, जल? और जय, व्हाट इज इट? धृति, ध्रुव, देव्यांश, ग्लोरी, ऋषभ, आदित्य इज द फास्टेस्ट. दैट्स ग्रेट. पूनम, आई एम नॉट इग्नोरिंग यू. Who was playing on the grass near Casper? His grandchildren, his neighbor's children, some strange kids. This is the easiest, I think. All of you should get this correct. If you are not just making a wild guess, of course. Very good. His grandchildren. Let's have a look at the leaderboard. Ayush is the fastest, and then Stinglicious, Simran, Jay है कि जल है, नहीं समझ में आ रहा है मुझे. आई थिंक इट्स जय, इट शुड बी जय. ओके, धृति, देव्यांश, ग्लोरी, ऋषभ, हिमांशु, आर्या. दैट्स ग्रेट. यस कौस्तव, आई हैव ऑलरेडी रेड योर नेम. व्हाट डिड पीटर किन फाइंड? A ball, an object that was large, round, and smooth, a box. Very good. An object that was large, round, and smooth. And what was that object, guys? Please tell me in the chat box. Yes, Ramesh, angel, ma'am. Oh my God. What is the trouble? Please tell me. Okay, guys, please tell me what was the large round thing that refers that he, that is referred to here? Anyone? Skull. Very good, Maya. Thank you so much for your answer. Okay, so Ayush is the fastest. Tinglisha, Simran, Jay, Dhriti, Devyansh, Glory, Rishabh, Ayush. Kitna Ayush hai? We have two Ayush and Arya. Next question. Yes, all of you are correct. The answer was skull. What did old Casper do when Peterkin came to him with the object? He threw it away. Casper took his head and sighed, and he took it to the police station. So, which is the correct answer? Okay, so old Casper shook his head and sighed. Yes. So when Peterkin, he came to him with this object, and this object is nothing, none other than that skull. Okay. So when he came with that skull, old Casper, he shook his head and he sighed. Very good. And next we have the leaderboard. Ayush. Okay, let us see who is the fastest right now. Ayush, Simran, Singlishas, Jay, Dhriti, Divyansh, Glory, Rishabh, Arya. Ayush is the fastest. So we have two students named Ayush. That's great. What did Casper say? He said that children should not play with a skull. He said that they should inform the police. He said that the skull belongs to a poor soldier who died in the battlefield. Good, good, good. Yes. He said that the skull belongs to a poor soldier who died in a battlefield, in that battle. Very good. I am Ayush with the club icon, ma'am. Okay. Oh, the one who's the fastest. Okay. So Ayush, Simran, Stinglicious, Jay, Dhriti, Devyansh, Glory, Rishabh, Arya, Ayush. Next question. What figure of speech is used in the line, "It was a great victory"? Irony, simile, or both? Come on. Beta ji, you have to answer fast, Cargo ji, and then your name will definitely come up. Irony, very good. So it was a great victory, as I explained this in the beginning of the session itself, when I explained about the great victory. So definitely it is an irony. Okay, so Simran, Stinglicious, Jay, Driti, Glory, Devyansh, Rishabh, Arya. Arya is the fastest. And then both Ayush together. Great, great, great. Next one. What happened to Casper's family in the war? His family was killed in the war, his house was burned, and they had to flee, or both? Are Megha, Lelia ji, aapka naam. I have taken your name. I am good, Smriti. What about you? Yes, absolutely correct. His house was burned and they had to flee. Excellent. Arey, thank you, Ramesh, for your compliment. Thank you so much. Yes, Pushpa, I have taken your name. Stinglicious, Driti, Jay, Glory, Rishabh, Arya, Ayush, Simran, Ayush, Anjali. Very good. What is Wilhelmine's reaction to the description of the war? She found it as a wicked thing. She considers war as heroic. She does not have any reaction. Are, thank you, Arjun. Thank you so much. Ramesh ji is my diehard fan. Oh my God. That's a pleasure. I'm glad to hear that. Yes, Ananya, I've taken your name. Yes, all of you are right. Like, most of you are right. She found it as a wicked thing. So, Wilhelmine said that war is a wicked thing because it is causing so much of destruction, right? So, with the help of Wilhelmine, actually, the poet is trying to, you know, make us question the validity of war, right? So, very good. Okay, Bhavya, Driti, Jay, Glory, Rishabh, Arya, Simran is the fastest. Both Ayush together and then Anjali. Great, guys, great. Why does the poet use a skull? Last question, and I discussed this. To make the readers frightened, to emphasize on the futility of war, because the poet loved skulls. Yes, absolutely correct. So he used skull to, you know, emphasize on the futility of war, to point out at the destruction, the horrors caused during a war, and stating that if it is causing so much of horror and, you know, casualties on both sides, then what is so great about it? What is, you know, so honorable about it? What is so glorious about it, right? So that is the question he is constantly harping upon, and he wants us to pinpoint that very question, right? So he raises that very issue. Bhavya is the winner for today's mentee. Congratulations, and congratulations, all of you have done an amazing job. Yes. So, bachche log, maza aaya aaj ke mentee mein? Yes or no? Did you enjoy today's mentee? So if you have enjoyed, what you need to do? Kya karna aap logo ko? What do you need to do? Cat to hai nahi, jab kal thi to maine dikha diya. Ab jab phir aayegi to phir se dikha dungi. Okay, so you know that you have to like, share and subscribe. So please do that. Theek hai bachcha log? Please show your love, show your support by liking, subscribing and sharing. So thank you so much. Take care. We will meet again in the next session. Till then, take care. Bye-bye. See you all. Love you all.